In this screencast, we're going to discuss the idea of scaling. And why would we scale? Well, most of the problems that we do in material and energy balances involve quantities that are easy to work with and are smaller or larger than we actually need them to be. So in order to go from our model system to one that's more realistic, we use this method of scaling. And what this procedure allows you to do is you change the values of your model system by a proportional amount. And this is what's known as a scaling factor. And when you scale, you change the amounts, for example, of your flow rates. However, you keep the proportions or the compositions the same. So let's look at an example. Let's say you have an aqueous solution. It's 35 weight percent NaCl, which I'll just call salt here. So it's 65% water, and it enters a crystallizer where 5 kilograms per hour of water are evaporated. And what you do is you produce 15 kilograms per hour of crystals, and that's suspended in a solution that is 25 weight percent salt. In addition, we'll have this mass of the feed. If we solve this problem, what we find is that this mass of the feed is 100 kilograms per hour, and the mass of the solution is 80 kilograms per hour. However, what if you wanted to produce 1,000 kilograms of crystals per hour instead of the 15 that we have in this system? So we need to calculate a scaling factor. And the scaling factor is this ratio of what we need. So what we need is 1,000 kilograms per hour, and we divide it by what our model produces, which is 15 kilograms per hour. And when we calculate that ratio, we get 66.7, which is what's known as our scaling factor. And so what can we do with that? Well, we can multiply any flow rate in our system to find out what flow rate or exiting flow rate we would need for 1,000 kilograms per hour of crystals. So let's start with the amount of feed. So for 15 kilograms per hour of crystals, we needed 100 kilograms per hour of feed. But here we multiply it by our scaling factor and find that in order to produce 1,000 kilograms per hour of crystals, we would need a feed rate of 6,667 kilograms per hour. We can do the same thing to find out how much water would be evaporated. So we use this scaling factor again, and we find that that would be 333 kilograms per hour of water. And finally, if we look at the solution, which is 80 kilograms per hour, multiplying it by the scaling factor tells us that we would produce 5,333 kilograms per hour of solution when we got 1,000 kilograms per hour of crystal. What if instead, though, your system was designed so you could only handle 7 kilograms per hour of crystals? Now what we have to do is scale down the system. So we take what we're going to need, which is 7 kilograms per hour of crystal, and divide it by what we got from our model, which is 15 kilograms per hour, And our scaling factor is 0.467. So now our feed is going to be 100 kilograms per hour times our scaling factor, which is 0.467, or 46.7 kilograms per hour. In other words, to produce 7 kilograms per hour of crystals, we need to feed 46.7 kilograms per hour of our 35 weight percent aqueous solution. And we use the same scaling factor again for the water. So our water is just 5 kilograms per hour multiplied by this scaling factor, which gives us 2.3 kilograms of water that's evaporated. And finally, our exiting solution is 80 kilograms per hour times the scaling factor, which gives us 37.3 kilograms per hour of exiting solution. Note that although these flow rates change depending on our scaling factor, the composition of each of these flows will remain the same.